I'm Elizabeth, and we are doing our third video with wool. This time we're going to make a hat, a woolen hat. And I know the summer is coming, but gives you some practice. Here we have wool. Usually we make the wool here at the farm from our own wool, but I take it you can't find that. This is called roving. And you can buy that on eBay anywhere. It's about $2 or $3 an ounce. For a hat, we use nearly 4 ounces. So this is 3.5 ounces divided in two, because the hat has 2 sides. And I might even divide it up again. But for now, this is the wool we're going to use for our hat. I measured it on this cute Weight Watchers scale, which we don't need anymore now. Poof. To make the hat, we are gonna felt the wool. Felt it. Is it felted? Felted or filted? Felt. I think in Dutch it's felt, and in American it is felt. So felting makes it stiff. And it happens because of agitation. Agitation and so like this. We're using a pattern. This is one for a hat with a 2-inch or nearly 3-inch brim. We're going to put the wool first. You pull it from here. You don't hold this tight because then you can't get it out. You hold this loosely and little plucks come out like that. And you go around the edges. I'll take this off for a minute, then it is clearer. Go around the edges of your pattern and you lay them like shingles. See, this is the end. This is fuzzy, and you put it over the fuzzy, like shingles. And you follow the edges of the hat until you have it all filled up. And I know it seems like a lot of work, but it is such joyous work to make something from wool without having to kill the animal. So you remember we made the fleeces in our other video, and that is from shorn wool and not from killed animals, because we don't like them. So this is around the edges. Fill up the middle. There's a lump. It's a tedious, but it's worth it. And the second layer, here's still a little piece of hay in there. The second layer, we're going to do the same way. But we're putting this fuzzy stuff a little bit over the edge. See? Across from what we have. And that makes the bonding of the 2 sides, because the hat has this side and the other side. And then you wonder, how are you going to get into it? Now that's the next.
So you're doing a little crisscross action.
Yeah, crisscross action here. With a little bit of the what you're holding goes on the inside and the soft goes on the out. That's the second layer we're doing. All the way around. And this part, this is the bottom part Oh, that was very thin. Here. So this was 1 1/4, yeah. Fill up the middle. Doesn't matter, but goes across from what you already had. How did we go? Oh yeah, we should go this way. Zigzagging it, because that makes the wool catch when you're agitating it. So we have this 2 layers on this side. Now I'm going to put a piece.
I think there needs to be a piece right there.
Poof. There. But this is going to get another 2 layers. So eventually we have everything. We put a little piece of, this is a part of a curtain, over it. Spray it with warm, soapy water. The soap I've used in here is Ajax dishwash detergent, or any soap will do. Ivory soap, soap that you got for Christmas that you don't like, anything will do. And now you flatten it and get the air out of the wool. I'm doing it this way because we want to turn it around, and otherwise they all those little pieces that we put on will fall off. We have to start all over again. See, this looks a little bit empty too. So when we have it all flattened out, the air out of it, see, it's bubbling up here. When the air is out of it, we'll turn it over. See if there's enough room here to turn it over. There. And as you can see, the edges that we have we fold them over. These fuzzy edges. Well, let's wait. We first put on a layer. Oh, from this side, we put on a layer that goes along the border of the, they call this pattern, you can make those yourself from, well, we made them from plasticky stuff that we got from Inman Package. But you can also make it from an old placemat, actually from anything. You could make it out of cardboard and throw it away when you're all done.
Does the cardboard soak up the water though?
Yeah, so cardboard soaks up the water, becomes real yucky, but then it's easy to take out too. It's just whatever you have. So do this along the edges. The shingle way that we did, follow the outline of the pattern.
It's the same process that we did on the first side?
First, same process.
And you do 2 layers.
Well, the first layer we do following the pattern, and then we're going to fold over what we have from the, what we stuck out from the last one.
Oh,
it
yeah.
is to join the 2 sides so that you don't get an hole in the middle of your hat. Now we did 1 layer, and we have this sticking out fuzz from the other layer, and we fold it. I wetted it a little bit, otherwise it doesn't stick, carefully over. Remember that we had a layer this way and a layer that way. Now we follow the exact pattern and fold over the fuzz. We have only one layer on this side. Fold over the fuzz. Fold it over. Keep the pattern in there. That's the trick. See, you just fold it over what you just laid down. And now we're going to do the second layer on this side to dry my hands. And the second layer is going to be with the fuzzies outside. Remember we talked about that? You pull it and this a little bit and leave it on the outside. So that is going to be folded over next time to the other side to make a nice . Can you see that? The fuzzies are here. We're going to fold that over. This is the second layer. Spray it with warm soapy water. The whole thing. Get the air out of it. You have to be careful because it kind of, you move it too much. Put your hand on and take it off like that. Don't push it down, the air comes out. Then I'm going to turn it over. And again, do another two layers on the other side. Just like the beginning. See how flat it gets? Here's still air in it, see it? This is flat, so push it down. It makes it connect with the layers will interconnect. And we're going to turn it over again. And this is very tricky because you have to remember where you are. This has two layers and that has two layers. I've had it once that I forgot where I was. And I ended up with a hat that had four layers here and two layers on the other side. This is our first side. See how nice that is? It's a creamy. It makes a difference what kind of wool you use. There is merino wool that's very, very soft and easily felted. And then there is the Corriedale, which is a little coarser. And it takes a little longer, that but depends on the length of the wool and all of that. But we can't go into that. It visually, working with it, you just can feel it, how it works. Whatever your wool is. So this is going to be the third layer of the first side. Third layer of the first side. So we follow the edges again.
Do you do this first before you turn over the edges?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, yes, to get a sort of a rhythm to it. You know, one go and one go, one go, one. Mm-hmm. So I'm first following the pattern. Oh, what is that word? The
shingles?
In a shingle fashion.
So is this the last part?
This is the last layer, but we did it with the fuzzy sticking out, and we're going to fold those over. So first we'll take the air out of this. And there are times that you can, you know, when you are at this point, you could stop. Make yourself a cup of coffee or a glass of wine, whatever you're into. And then continue in a half an hour or so. Just at least you don't forget where you were. Like, did I have two sides on this side or two sides on that side? Should the fuzzies be out, should the fuzzies be in? No. So we have this now folded over. And we fold over the edges following the pattern. Again, poof, I lost the whole beginning of this. Fold this over. Fold it over. This is the bottom of the hat. And eventually we'll cut that open. Because now you have two parts. One. And plastic, or the model is on the inside. So we will get that out eventually. But for now it's staying in. So now we have both sides, four layers interconnected on the sides because we had them like this. And now we're going to felt it. First we're just going to agitate it a bit with this on there, because if you don't, you still move the wool around. In the beginning, you just go like this, get all the, and then you can slowly put your fingers down.
So the netting's on top of it?
Netting is on top of it.
Okay.
Pay attention to the edges. Let me see if I can touch it yet. See that? It has wrinkles and everything. Don't worry about that. They come up, they go away. You don't have to even out the wrinkles. You have to keep the shape. Keep the shape in there. Just massage this as you go.
Are you pressing down very hard or
no,
softly?
Softly. Because if you push too hard, the wool comes along. The wool still comes along, it is not felted yet. But this was such nice, clean, see the air coming up? Clean wool that it probably felts very easily.
So how long do you do that for?
20 minutes on each side. Into it now for 5 minutes with four hands. We did it together. So the idea is 20 minutes, but you can already feel it becoming leathery. Yeah, I think that's a word, leathery. It's not... See, when you pluck it up, well, can you see this? You still get a whole layer. The idea is that eventually all of that is united together. Now, it's only 5 minutes of the 20 minutes, but it feels already like good. Like, I don't know, pizza bread, pizza dough. Nice, smooth pizza dough, but it's still spongy in the inside, so that means we are not through 4 layers yet. Maybe the first 2 layers are pizza dough and the rest is coming. So I'm pushing deeper now. I'm not just wiping and brush, but I'm really pushing deep. Okay, we did this side now with 4 hands, so we're treating 30 minutes. But it feels so beautiful.
20 minutes or 30 minutes?
Oh, 15.
But you should do it 20 minutes, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
It should be 20 minutes. And now you can pull it up. See, and it does not, the whole thing does not come up. You just get some hair.
And you really can feel the difference. It's squishy when it's not felted right, and it does feel like pizza dough after it's...
And I'll show you. I'll turn it over. Well, we should really put this over it. And we could have had that under it, but we didn't. I'll show you the difference from felted and not felted. Pizza dough and wool. See?
Oh, yeah.
And remember we did this one and we could barely get up a hair.
Nice.
So we have to felt this for another 20 minutes. And then we are done with the shaping of the head. So now we have 20 minutes on this side and 20 minutes on that side. And I showed you that the wool is stuck to each other. Now we're going to have the rolling part. So this is the hat. In it is the model. Taking this off. Put that in the sink. Take. Oops, let me lay down for a minute. Take a towel would be good, but I'm having a tea towel here. And we're going to roll it up. And go like this. Move it back and forth. Maybe this is going to be in our way too. Move it back and forth. Sort of you count till 50. And now we're going to, because it was rolled up this way, now we're going to roll it up this way. See here we have a thin plate. Turn it over, see here? The plastic comes through. But that's the edge of the rim, so
it'll be okay.
It'll be okay. We'll cut bottom. Remember, these are the sides. This is the rim. So we'll cut the rim open.
How did you decide on this shape?
We have different shapes. I have one that goes like this. But this, when we pull it over later, it makes a nice rim. Others don't have a rim. See, here comes the model. And we can use it again. So if it had been cardboard, it would have just been a big mess. And we cut a piece off. Look how beautiful it is on the inside, felted. Sometimes the insides are prettier than the outsides even. It's a little light around this edge here. But we can always put a flower on there. So now this thing is full of soap. And what I do is I put it under hot water. But in the meantime, I can also just put it in a pot and cook it, which I will do. We've cooked what we made. And we rinsed it, and most of the soap is out of it. Now, this is the... You can buy these things on eBay. when you want to be a millinery and make hats.
That's kind of a cool edge too, don't you think? It's even before you have finished it, if you wanted to do something more casual, like play around with a hat, making a different style of hat.
Yeah, but we want to make a hat. So we put this over the mold. The mold happens to be an antique mold, but my very first hat, without having a mold, I made on this aluminum. Is that aluminum? No, stainless steel. See? You get about the same
this
shape.
This hat
is made on this mold.
And this is the bowl.
Yeah. So this is a cute hat. And it is empty. You can put flowers and all kind of things on it. Plain hat.
Cute.
This hat becomes more of a formal shape hat for a fedora or whatever.
Fedora.
Fedora. I like the round ones. And here we call our hats on the farm. Not farm hats, but we call them Montana hats. Because they come out with a 2-inch or a 2.5-inch brim. And they make us look like, I don't know, why do we call them Montana hats? It's just, that felt,
I think it just reminds you
good.
Of, old school cowboy hat.
Yeah.
So I think of Montana, the state of Montana.
So we form this around the mold. And we could felt this a little bit more in because there was a little light spot there. I don't know if you have a big hole or something, you can always do dry felting. Needle felting, they call that. This is called wet felting. See, nice shape. And then when you have all of that, nice trimmed around the bowl, kind of there. Then what I do is I put a rope around it so that it stays in this size, and then I'll pull out the frame, the brim.
This is actually kind of a cool brim if you were to go to more modern art.
Yeah.
Like, look how, I love the folds in this. I would almost leave it just like that. That's beautiful. And put a flower in it. I love that.
Yes. But that is the next step. Then you're doing the millinery part. I'm now making a hat.
Mm-hmm.
And here's the little rope, which is like, I think, oh, my hands are slippery. From a kite. Kite line? Is that it?
Yeah, like twine.
Yeah. So now there's a little rope around the brim, and I'm stretching out. This part. And it's constant massaging again with soap in it to make it smooth. And it takes a while to get this. Here's a big lump. Now you could leave it like this. And you call it Ollie.
Looks like a sailor hat now.
Yes. So we get it done. Down brim.
Wow, look at that.
It's like magic, huh?
One thing I like about working in wool is it's very organic. It's like, you and I had talked about this before, like it's like a living fiber. It's like clay.
It is.
And it really responds to your touch.
And if you are into things more than I am, I like plain. But you can dye the wool. You can decorate it with other colors. Like have a yellow and red circles in it.
How would you do that? Like put...
In the time that we were felting it, we could have put other colors in.
Oh, like just like swaths of yellow?
Yeah.
Cool.
Other colors wool. Now, there we go. The brim is coming out.
Wow.
And I don't think, because we made this little mistake here, that the brim is going to be 3 inches. So now we have this all stretched out, but long and behold, what we don't like, there's this short spot in the brim. Which is too bad. So the brim can only be this long. I would have liked it longer, but well, we can still stretch it a bit. Yeah, maybe we should stretch it a bit.
So stretching it, you just kind of pull outwards and work it. It's amazing how strong, we were talking about how strong it feels, even though we're making it thinner, because the fibers are condensing, the hat has a strong structure to the fabric. It's really cool. It's like clay, it's like a living thing, it's so cool.
So this is 2 inches. But we need a pen or a pin. We have it here at 4 centimeters. So we'll go around. Wait a minute. This is 4. I didn't finish the edges, but I put a ribbon around it. Which is actually a tie.
Let's see it on you.
Wait a minute, not all through showing it. And I put a sweatband in it, which is the same tie. And the word sweatband does not sound nice, but but you need it because it's wool and it gets itchy. Also, it has my name in it. Can you see that? This is my hat.
Aww.
So this, you can play with it. You can put, you know, sunflowers on it. You can put everything on your hat. Shinies,
could whatever. Could even have those, like,
a voile.
Yeah, little jingles.
Yeah, jingles, buttons. This is where the creativity starts. You've got a canvas and you can make it beautiful.
That's beautiful.
Thank you for watching my video. Next time we do another felting project.